Stretching along the western edge of South America and hemmed in between the towering Andes Mountains and the expansive Pacific Ocean, the world's southernmost country might appear to be isolated in its own small part of the globe. But it's here, in the land of the poets, where connection reigns supreme. From close-knit family bonds to cross-border international coalitions, Chileans have harnessed the power of partnership, along with a vast array of natural resources and climate types, to create a growing, sustainable economy and future. Here, in Chile, we'll see firsthand how technology and tradition combine to form cloud cultures. I've just touched down in Santiago, a thriving metropolis that serves as the country's economic engine, and a place where the beating heart of innovation is rivaled only by the hustle and bustle of its growing population. That growth, it seems, is both a cause and effect of Chile's expansive international relationships, creating a multicultural exchange of natural resources and building an economy that has fostered massive innovations in sustainable technology. I'm looking forward to exploring some of the natural wonders here in Chile. But first, I'm meeting with my friend Ninoska Amo, Nino for short, who's offered to help me get my bearings and cover some ground as we explore her home country. She's asked me to meet her at Cerro San Cristobal, the most expansive park in Santiago. Let's hope I don't get lost.
Hey, hello, Corey.
How are you? Good to see you. Oh.
Glad you made it. Yeah. Chilean.
One kiss.
Welcome to Santiago.
Yeah.
This is Parque Metropolitano.
Thank you.
That's the Andes mountain chain. And for you to find your way around the city, we have a trick that works only in Chile, though.
Okay.
Right hand, pointing to the Andes.
Okay, got it.
Immediately left, west, the ocean.
Okay.
North, the desert. And then behind you, south, forest and glaciers, all in one country.
I have the directions, but I don't remember what's what. But
no worries.
Okay, you'll have to remind me later.
Sure will. Here's
what
something for us to drink. This is mote con huesillo.
Mote con huesillo.
Perfect, yeah. It's sweet and dried peach. It's sweet drink,
oh my
dessert.
Gosh. Okay.
That's it.
It's a drink dessert, my favorite.
Mm-hmm.
Mm. Oh, that's lovely.
It is. Let me show you my favorite spot here in the park, an even better view.
Okay. I'll keep drinking.
Yeah. See?
Wow.
What did I tell you? Best view in the park.
Really gorgeous. That's awesome. So I had heard you spent some time in Mongolia.
I did.
What were you doing there?
Had the most wonderful opportunity to share with the community and train yoga teachers in Mongolia.
Oh my gosh. Yeah. So what brought you back then to Chile after that time in Mongolia?
Chile will always be, you know, in my soul. I think it's the relationships we have with the rest of the world. Those relationships are really key to our growth and sustainability.
Yeah, sustainability is really important here in Chile.
Yeah.
And so I'm excited to meet Daniel from Colbun. They do a bunch of renewable energy and apparently beautiful solar farms.
Yeah.
I'm really excited to go out there and see those and talk with him. Yeah.
Chile is really leading the way in renewable energy. Very excited for
it's
you
amazing.
To see that.
Yeah.
I'll be meeting Jairo from Kilimo.
Huh?
They're doing some groundbreaking work with sustainability, in particular water management for greater efficiency and yield.
Yeah. And my last trip, I'm going to ESO to see a telescope literally out of this world. And very excited to see sort of the views and the possibility for science and the connection, both with the community around from a science perspective, but then also nature.
Fantastic.
It's going to be great.
On my way out of town, I couldn't miss an opportunity to add a few new dance moves to my repertoire. In this case, the national dance of Chile. And with Nino off to explore farmland east of Santiago, I'm heading to a very different kind of farm in the north. At Ovejeria Farm, they harvest energy from the sun. Meeting me here today is Daniel Gordon, the Sustainability and Corporate Affairs Manager of Colbun, a power company focused on bringing renewable energy to all of South America.
This is quite an impressive operation you've got here.
Yeah, welcome to Ovejeria Solar Plant. And this is the lab where we learned on how to construct and operate these types of technologies.
An impressive lab. Colbun got started in hydroelectric. Is that correct?
Yeah, we were very vocal because system here depended on fossil fuel for a couple decades.
Yeah.
Hydro was the first and only renewable that Chile had.
Wow.
Until solar came mainstream. We have 27 plants right now.
27 plants.
different technologies.
You mind showing me around a little bit?
Let's walk. We have a very diversified matrix in terms of energy generation. So we got water in the south, we got solar in the north, you know, one of the driest deserts in the world.
Yeah.
We got some good wind also,
yeah,
because it's helping us push energy transition and accelerate.
So that energy transition, like how are things changing for all of Chile in delivering of energy?
It's a challenge. Renewables are variable within the day, within the theme,
right,
within
sun's the season. Not up all day.
Exactly.
Exactly.
But we're seeing stuff like what happened a couple months ago, that during certain hours of the day, the 100% of the entire electrical needs of the country was supplied with renewable.
What are some of the practical scenarios that you're seeing AI help?
It's coming fast. For example, prediction models for resources like wind or sun.
Yeah.
It's in there. This right here, what's the frequency on we need to clean the panels?
Clean the panel, repair.
Like so this. That's a lot of machine learning. And we're doing a lot of data classification, a lot of applications that are helping us out in that,
I see,
that sense.
So thinking about the long term, what does the future look like for you and Colbun?
It's hard to predict now. You know, last 5 years have been crazy. So that's why we're diversifying in technology, diversifying in countries that we want to be into, diversifying in kinds of products and services that we want to provide. And that also means that we can't work alone.
You're creating those bonds throughout all of LATAM, but then even beyond.
Exactly.
Fantastic.
Colbun stands out as a leader in renewable energy and innovation, not only on a local level, but expanding into other South American countries and beyond. It's the kind of cooperation that Chileans are known for and that continues to propel the nation towards a more sustainable future. This spirit is also the driving force for Kilimo, a Latin American startup with a goal to address one of the most important resources to farming, water. Nina was on her way to Finca Casabermeja, a lemon farm in Chile's dry region. There, she's meeting with the owner of the farm, Sebastian Munoz, and Jairo Trad, the founder and CEO of Kilimo.
Welcome to Finca Casabermeja.
Can you tell us a bit about your farm?
We are in a family business. This is a sustainable and organic lemon farm. So we are here probably like 15 years now.
And Jairo, could you tell us how your startup Kilimo fits into organic, sustainable lemon farming?
Kilimo is an irrigation management solution. We help farmers make better irrigation decisions using data and AI to improve the efficiency of water use at the farm. We use a combination of satellite data and weather data to model how much water a farm uses, and we provide irrigation advice on top of that.
Do you want to take a tour?
Yes, please.
To your farm. Please follow me.
What's the reception like from, you know, farmers when you presenting your solutions?
We approach the farmers understanding that they need to ease into the technology. So where we train farmers how important it is to manage water and to use our technology in our solution.
We started working with Kilimo 1 year ago with good results. You know, with the platform they give us, we managed to reduce the water use in up to 12%. This area, in particular, is very dry.
I see.
To manage and to reduce the water impact, but not impact the lemons, is a very big concern.
I see.
Right? So our partner with Kilimo helped us reduce the water use, but not sacrificing the production, right? Sure. Let me show you the irrigation system, show you more what we do with Kilimo.
Yeah.
Okay. So this basically is the irrigation system. You can see the pumps. They all run with solar power, but also we have a reservoir. We have a technology called variables. It help us to reduce the evaporation of the irrigation system.
So here is where you execute the advice that Kilimo provides to the farm.
Can you tell me a little bit more how you're using data and AI and cloud technology for your solution?
Yes, of course. There is an enormous amount of data available that where we use machine learning and AI to produce a specific piece of information that we need. That's called real evapotranspiration. That is how much water each specific plot is using every given day. We use AI where we distill all the information into a plain text advice. So our tool tells the farmer you have to irrigate half an inch in the next week.
Mm-hmm. Fantastic, yeah, and very personalized.
It's personalized, and AI is great at summarizing things, so it helps
exactly.
a lot.
Exactly, fantastic.
Do you want some fresh lemonade?
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay, let's follow me.
Thank you so much for this refreshing lemonade. Of course, you know, water management and agriculture is very important for Chile, but you're, you know, also with projects in other countries in Latin America and Central America.
Yes, currently we're operating in 7 countries, mm-hmm. And we are providing water stewardship projects to companies across 15 watersheds. In Kilimo, we have a clear purpose that has been written for several years now, that is reshaping the value of water in agriculture. The value that goes into every lemon that we might use is heavily undervalued. So finding this model where we can put in a specific value of a farmer being efficient with water is very important for us, and we want to take that idea all over the world.
And you do that through innovation and technology.
Yes.
Well, cheers, gentlemen, for a great day. Thank you so much for your time.
Cheers. Cheers.
While farmers like Sebastian are some of the first to suffer from water shortages, they're also some of the most impactful when it comes to cultivating a solution. By teaming up with Kilimo, the duo is able to leverage AI and generate novel solutions to a worldwide problem. Meanwhile, I've just landed at a location that feels, well, pretty out of this world. This is the Atacama Desert, the driest place on Earth, and a spot where actual astronauts train for potential missions to Mars. While for some, the harsh terrain serves as an extraterrestrial training ground, to others, it represents a unique kind of paradise.
How are you?
I'm here to meet with one such person.
It's great to be here.
Yes, well, welcome to the European Southern Observatory. And, well, first you need to put this on.
Okay. Safety first.
Safety first.
I like that. The European Southern Observatory, European, is in Chile.
Yes, it's in Chile.
Why is that?
Well, the reason is because more than 60 years ago, somebody from Chile was able to convince, you know, the Europeans and Americans to come here and to check at the quality of the Chilean skies.
So give me the rundown of what we're looking at here. And, you know, if you can share, how many UFOs do you have here?
Well, I cannot tell you that.
Okay.
You know, if I tell you,
I will join the UFOs.
Yes, you will join the UFOs. We have them, you know, below ground. You know, we leave them loose at night.
Okay, don't tell me that then.
Okay. What we have here, what we really have here, is 4 8-meter telescopes. This is the most modern optical and infrared telescope in the world. Do you want to go and take a look inside?
Do I? Let's go.
Let's go.
So what is this big yellow thing, and what does it do?
This big yellow thing is an instrument.
Okay.
This is what we use instead of using our own eyes. These instruments capture the light from the stars or whatever object.
Really cool.
Yeah, whatever object we are observing. And then it takes the image, you know, to a computer screen where we have astronomers and technicians looking and studying at those images.
I see. So it's basically a really fancy eyeball.
Yes.
Okay,
yes.
Very cool. There's a lot of technology involved here. How are you using the cloud and AI in addition to the huge amount of, you know, world-class physical technology that I'm looking at right in front of me?
Well, one thing is that these instruments, the more modern they get, the more information they capture.
Uh-huh.
Uh-oh. What's going on?
We seem to be moving.
Yes.
Okay.
So right now, we're getting ready to nighttime.
Yeah.
And at this moment, every day, the telescope has to test its mechanical system.
I see.
Now, let's go back to artificial intelligence.
Yes.
Some of these instruments, they can capture the image of millions of stars. And we need to study those stars very quickly.
Yes.
And we cannot do it with millions of people. So we need these algorithms that are going to check each one of those stars and see if there is anything, you know, weird about them. And then it's going to raise a flag. And a human being is going to look at that star with more detail.
So it's finding the interesting things to then pass on to the human to go do the next level of work.
Yes. With these telescopes, we're finding planets that are similar to Earth.
Okay.
But we cannot study much of the details. So with the telescope that we're building now, It is called the ELT, which means extremely large telescope. With extremely large, we're going to be able to study the atmospheres in those exoplanets.
Wow.
To see if there is, for example, nitrogen, well, oxygen, ozone, water vapor.
Yeah.
Huge amounts of methanes.
Of course.
May indicate that we have a lot of cows digesting.
Space cows.
Space cows, yes. So we may be able to find space cows.
I mean, that's what everyone's dream.
Yeah, it cannot be cooler than that.
Well, it's probably gotten dark now, so should we head outside and take a look at these amazing stars that I've heard so much about?
Exactly. All right, this is the best place to do that, so we should go.
All right, okay. Very good. Well, Luis, thanks for agreeing to wear these awesome hats.
They're pretty cool.
Yeah, we brought them so we could have a conversation under a beautiful sky, but didn't want to disrupt the light for the telescopes. So.
Yeah, in fact, that's something very important because this place here where we are right now, this is a sanctuary in terms of light pollution.
Which is why we can see such beautiful, amazing sky. So what does it mean to you, being a native Chilean, to have this here?
It's amazing. I mean, so one of the important things about having this big infrastructure for science here is to try to answer the question of how can we bring social benefits to the whole world, but also for the people that live around the observatories. All the technology, the innovation, the use of artificial intelligence, right. All that comes together and makes a learning place where people could come and learn the way we do things, and then they can apply what they learn here, the experience in whatever
to other
they
industries.
Do.
Yeah.
And it's in that way they could help society.
So when you look, if you close your eyes and think 5 years into the future, what do you see? Is it space cows?
Yeah, I see space cows, but I see that we are looking for those answers that are very deeply in our minds and hearts about are we alone in the universe?
Right.
And we are addressing those questions from here, you know, from Chile.
After a stunning night in the desert, I'm heading back to Santiago to catch up with Nino, to reflect on our experiences here in Chile.
Hello, Nino, how are you?
Hey, Corey.
Good to see you again.
Good to see you again. Thanks for meeting me here.
Yeah, of course, yeah. Where are we?
This is the Baha'i Temple. It's a temple that welcomes all religions. It's a great place for connection with nature, with others.
Yeah.
Feels fitting.
Yeah, my conversation with Colbun really showed that connection with nature. Their focus on sustainable future really came across, especially as you look out upon the fields of solar panels. There's a beautiful, almost as beautiful as this. Wow, look at how beautiful that is.
Yeah, all of Santiago.
Yeah. So tell me about how your conversation went.
Oh, mine went great. Kilimo's doing such important work. It's amazing to think what technology and perhaps AI could do for sustainable and efficient agriculture.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I had the luck to be able to go to the ESO to see the Very Large Telescope.
Wow.
And Luis talked a lot about how it creates connections with scientists all over the world, scientists in Chile, and certainly making connections or attempting to make connections with whatever life may be out there, including he's very excited about space cows.
Space cows.
Yeah, huh. Well, that's pretty much it. That space cows is what he's looking for.
I hope he finds them.
I hope he does too.
You know, it's beautiful because although you think Chile is geographically isolated, it is through these kind of innovations that we are establishing deep relationships with the rest of the world.
Yeah, I love that.
So, Corey, I heard you were a natural at a national dance, the cueca, that you already had some experience. So
I did.
Chilean.
Oh, my goodness.
Within you. Wow. Want to try this one out?
Yes, I mean, immediately.
Please.
So, okay, let's try this on.
Like so.
Is that right? Okay.
And wouldn't be complete without the hat.
Let's put it on.
Ah,
oh, this is perfect.
It looks so great in you.
Thank you. I wear it with honor, and I will practice the cueca every day and come back and dance it for all to see.
One thing I've noticed during my time here in Chile is the deep connection people share with the world around them. A connection not only to the land itself, but with people and organizations who share a common vision for a brighter future, wherever they are. From the vibrant streets of Santiago to the natural wonders beyond the city, it's clear this is a nation proud of its ability to foster collaboration on an international scale. And it's a lesson I look forward to taking with me on my next adventure.